Hi, I'm Tasneem Noor and I am the Faith Connector. And today I have a really important question to ask you, and that is, who is in the driver's seat? Yes, who is the driver driving your life, your decisions, your choices, your experience of life? Today I really want to talk to you about three possible drivers that could be driving your life at any given moment of time. These drivers are your mind, your heart, and your ego. So let's break it down and see what purpose each of these drivers have to play and what benefit they have to offer us. Your heart is your inner knowing. It's your intuition. It's that part of you is that is just aware. It's like, think of it as the map, right? The map that has it all laid out, and your heart has access to it. Your mind is the navigator. It sees what's out there on the map. It sees what's happening around you in your environment, and it's processing all this information to come up with options and the best possible way of getting to your destination. So it's the processor. Your ego is, for the purpose of this video, think of it as the communicator of your needs. It wants to tell you what you need in this moment as you continue on this journey of life. So that's your ego. Now, let me take a real example to really show how each of wh what really, how this these drivers actually influence us and our decision making, our choices, our experiences, and how easy it is to actually switch drivers with awareness. And the example that I want to use today is actually this video itself. Because you see, I have an intention that on a weekly basis, I'm going to share with you a powerful message that is meaningful to me and will be of service to you. But when I sat down today to do it, confession, I didn't really know what I was going to talk about. So I consciously put my heart into the driver's seat so I could get clarity on what my message was today and what it is that I really wanted to convey to you that was meaningful to me. Once I got clarity on the message that I wanted to talk about awareness and discernment of all the different voices and parts of us that influence our decisions, then I said, "Mind, come on in. It's your turn." And I put my heart in the passenger seat so my mind could really take charge of the steering wheel. I needed clarity of how to process my own message so I could communicate to you in a way that was effective and succinct. And guess what? It was my mind who came up with the idea of use the analogy of the driver who's in the driver's seat. So I hope my mind is doing a good job. It navigated well, and the example is resonating with you. The ego, my ego, not the one to be silent, very active indeed, started telling me all the things I needed, from the perfect background, the camera angle, to my hair, put it this way, my drink water, your throat is dry. And so I consciously chose to leave my mind in the driver's seat while I listened to my ego in the passenger seat. You see, I didn't want to put my ego in the driver's seat because my ego wants attention on all my needs right now in this moment. And that can be really distracting. So while staying focused on my goal of putting out this video, I listened to my ego, took action on my needs, and here I am ready and shooting this video now. Any guesses on who's in the driver's seat as I talk to you right now? Yep, you are correct. I switched drivers once again and went back to my heart. I'm using the framework, the navigation chart that my mind created to share my message. However, my heart is in the driver's seat because I'm sharing my message with you in an authentic way. There is no script. I'm just talking to you, so it comes across as being natural and real and meaningful to you, right? So my heart is the one who's in the driver's seat, and that's who you see right now. Who's in your driver's seat? I want to know. So connect with me on The Faith Connector. That's my social media and my website. I look forward to getting to know who's in your driver's seat. Bye.